Justin. Here's a picture of the new house our sponsor is giving you to take the place of your house that burned down. Didn't expect that, did you? Well, don't cry, Mrs. Weston. This is about ghosts. There's nothing to cry about. I have so much fun every day giving people things that they need. We're giving you this new house for the one that burned down when it caught fire from the candles on the birthday cake of your little son, George. And a whole new set of furniture. Isn't that wonderful? And a whole new wardrobe for the entire family. And you have Mrs. Cleo Morgan to thank for this because she was such a good sport and a good neighbor. Well, we'll see you tomorrow, folks, with another Good Neighbor program.
Hi. Oh, hi. This is such an entertaining program.
Oh, it looked like a million laughs.
No, it really is. They do so many wonderful things for people. I'm just mad about that program.
Look how much mail you got today.
Oh, thanks. Gee, here's one for Ricky, postmark Honolulu.
Honolulu?
Yeah, didn't you know?
Why, Lucy, you know I never look at your mail.
Oh, I wonder where it's from.
Mr. Jensen of the Royal Hawaiian. It says so on the back flap.
Wonder who he is. Hey, the flap's open a little bit. Maybe I can get it open some more.
Nope, it's stuck tight.
Can you see anything?
No, this envelope is so thick.
Boy, gee, they make them thick.
Yeah. Hey, wait a minute. It looks exciting, doesn't it? Awesome. Look at all those things.
Too bad we couldn't get the flap open.
Well, maybe we could. You never can tell.
Just cut it out, will you? Good morning, Ricky.
Oh.
Good morning.
Oh, hi, Ricky. We were just trying to find out if this letter was really for you. The name's kind of blurred. Yeah, yeah, it's for you.
Yeah, Ricky Ricardo.
Yeah.
That's me. Well, I'm late for rehearsal. I'll eat down at the club. Goodbye.
But, Ricky!
Yeah?
What about the letter?
Oh, it wasn't important.
Wasn't important?
No, it's just business, honey. Some millionaire, he wants me to take the band down to Hawaii with some entertainers and play a dance.
He says it wasn't important. My goodness, that's exciting. I've never been to Hawaii.
Neither have I.
Oh, Ricky, we have to figure out some way so that we can take Fred and Ethel along with us, too.
Two?
Yeah, two, as in besides me. Oh, now, Ricky, you wouldn't go to Hawaii without me.
Honey, we're only going for one night. We're coming right back.
I don't care. A short trip is better than no trip at all. Besides, you said you needed some entertainers. We could be the entertainers.
What are you going to call yourself? The Deadweight Trio?
Well, thanks a lot.
Now, wait a minute, Ethel. Don't get mad. This is no time to antagonize him. Now, listen, give me just one good reason why we can't all go to Hawaii.
Because I can't afford it, honey. I'm not making any money in this job. I'm losing money. I'm just taking it for the publicity value. Now, goodbye.
Oh, Ricky.
Well, that's that.
Oh, no, it isn't. I'm not giving up so easy.
Huh? Oh, for once, I'm glad to see that gleam in your eye. What do you have in mind?
Well, first, we've got to prove that we're good enough to take along.
Yeah?
But how?
How?
Yeah, now let me see.